The ANC in Gauteng is opposed to e-tolling in its current form. Now, the party ended its three-day provincial elective conference in Centurion yesterday. Some of the areas of focus included the economy, unity, and the upcoming local government elections. Well, for more on the story now, I'm joined in studio by Gauteng Premier David Makhura. Premier, thank you very much for your time after a busy weekend, and thank you for coming in. Looking at the headlines, looking at the stories coming out of the conference, e-tolls being one of the big issues. Some of the headlines suggesting that the president quite cross with the province at the moment. Have you ruffled feathers nationally?
Good morning, Yuveka, and thank you very much for the opportunity. We had a very successful provincial conference. I saw the story. I'm not convinced that it is a true representation of the situation. We have always worked very closely with our national leadership, including President Jacob Zuma. I think they quote me in the story that I said we understood why the president could not join the conference. He had commitments, but the leadership of the ANC was there more than we expected. We had lots of National Executive Committee members there. The Deputy President came to address. The Treasurer General was there. The Deputy Secretary General was there. So we had a lot of NEC members there, and we are satisfied with the work we did together to have a very successful conference. So it's good for the ANC.
How have they responded? We know that the provincial ANC is quite confident, like we said, that like you've said, that they can work. You can work with national government to sort out the issue, to sort out the disgruntlement over etolls and come to some kind of workable solution here. But how did they respond at the conference? Are they also willing? Do they feel the same way?
The ANC works in a very simple way, that when you have a conference, the views of the members of the ANC is what matters. When a conference has taken those decisions, if it's a provincial conference, that conference is the highest decision-making body. Mm. On issues that impact on the national situation, on national policy, we go and have discussions with our national leadership. If it's about national policy, we go to the next forum, which is the National General Council, and then the policy conference and the national conference. But if it's about issues affecting a province, those issues get dealt with by a provincial conference and the provincial executive committee.
But this is a bit of a difficult one for you, because this is a national road we're talking about that goes through the province. So how do you plan to work together to sort this
out? I think one of the important things I want to explain is that the conference did certainly look at the unhappiness throughout the province about the current e-toll system, and ANC members said they don't support the system in its current form. But we looked beyond that. We said one of the important things we want to do is to build the state-of-the-art infrastructure, roads, public transport infrastructure, electricity, water and sanitation infrastructure to grow this economy. So one of the things conference said we must do is to have a comprehensive discussion on the funding of infrastructure, without which you can't have a growing economy. So the e-toll discussion was just one thing. In its current form, conference was clear that the ANC doesn't support it.
In its current form, you're talking about just the amount, the costing, all of that, and just what it's doing to users' pockets.
Yes, because conference said, look, we support the user pay principle. There's a lot of other areas where the users must pay. But we also know that there are other areas in social and economic transformation that the state should bear the cost through a taxation system. So there's no issue that the user pay principle should be will continue to be supported. But you know the whole. That's why I don't want to talk a lot, because I have established a panel which is looking into that. The ANC conference said the provincial executive committee must go to the panel to make the ANC's presentation. You remember there are many stakeholders and participants and organizations, including parties, that will do the same. What is clear is that in its current form, it has lots of shortcomings that have to be relooked.
Premier, in case you were watching earlier, we did throw the question out to our viewers to ask what do they think about your announcement that you will work with national government. And a lot of people wanting to know why now? Why now has the ANC in Gauteng decided to go the other route? Why now are they, you know, why have they taken the stance at this stage? And does it have anything to do with the upcoming government elections?
Let me set the record straight. In 2011, when the first announcement was made on the etolls, I was the provincial secretary of the ANC. I issued a statement on behalf of the ANC that the etolls, as they are, would not be a good thing for the province. So it's not why now question. It would be arise from those who may not know that it is a long-standing position. When the etolls were actually first introduced, there was a lot of concern about the form that they will take. So in the ANC, in this province, it has been an issue that was raised many times. It's almost 4 years now that discussion. It's just that the public would have not known about it. But I'm saying to you, in 2011, I made a public statement already on behalf of the Provincial Executive Committee.
And yet they went ahead in December and implemented it, despite you saying that you've made a noise about it. How confident can the public be that you, as Premier, and that you, with your panel, would actually make a difference now, seeing as they don't seem to have heard that protest in the past?
Well, I am very pleased as the Premier of the province that many people, the communities in the province, there were public meetings held, there were meetings with stakeholders, consultations held, there were many submissions made. The panel tells me they've been receiving lots of submissions. That makes me happy. The panel will now evaluate all those submissions and make their report to me by the end of November. And when that report comes, I will take the report to the Provincial Executive Council, which is the Provincial Cabinet. And we are confident we will provide the appropriate way forward for our province. Once we have looked at the full impact of the etolls on the economy and the people of our province. And we must take a long-term view on this, not just the here and now. But we must also have a very clear perspective on how do we invest in public transport infrastructure, expand the public transport infrastructure for people to have many options before you force everybody on the line where they will be opposed to anything that is costly for them.
And just to give us some clarity, Premier, we're not going to see that it will be done away with completely, but in its current form, we're going to see it implemented in a different way. Is that what we're hoping for?
I you know, that report is going to come to me, so I would avoid preempting what the report will say. Okay. If you ask, the conference of the ANC is loud and clear that in its current form, it is too costly for
taxing
the people of the province.
All right. And then the other issue that came out about it over the weekend, and we saw the sort of back and forth over this, claims that you're being micromanaged by the chairman, Paul Mashatile, and you have dismissed those claims, saying that is absolutely not happening.
I have dismissed those claims. I must say that, you know, I'm glad that the journalist, Kloli, who was running the story, came back to me to apologize for that. It is somebody who's just disgruntled, who didn't get what they wanted out of the conference, who's trying to throw every stone at myself and Paul Mashatile. I have appointed my policy advisor, Mr. Duduzi Mbada, who I have known when I was still in the student movement. You know, I used to be the president of SASCO. I've known, I was his leader there. I worked with him for 8 years in the ANC as the provincial secretary. He was the provincial policy coordinator. He grew to a point and he was studying. And later in the years, when Paul Mashatile became the premier of Gauteng, I asked him to say there's a young man with very good skills here. Can he come and help you? And you remember Paul Mashatile later became the deputy minister and the minister. And he came back to me and said, can I take him with to national government? I said, yes, I will come back one day to get him back. And on the 20th, when I was appointed, the ANC said to me, I'm going to be the premier of the province. I said to Paul Mashatile, he was still the minister. I said to him, Comrade Paul, I want Mdu to come back as we had agreed some years ago that one day I will have him back. So Mduduzi Manana is somebody, Mbada, is somebody I have known for many years. He is a very solid expert on issues of governance. It has nothing to do with Paul Mashatile trying to micromanage me. But I think that story itself is an affront on Paul Mashatile's integrity and my intellect, that he is micromanaging me, as he's being made a boogeyman, and I'm being made somebody who has no authority. I'm saying I'm glad that the journalist who ran the story came back to me to apologize. So there's no basis. Okay. We work very well, and this I just want to say, over the next 5 years, all the policy positions that I have announced in the State of the Province address to move this biggest economy forward have been endorsed by the conference of the ANC. You are going to see Gauteng moving significantly forward in a very big way. This biggest economy is going to grow over the next 5 years. The ANC is fully behind everything we are doing in government.
Thank you very much. That's Gauteng Premier David Makhura with us this morning.
Thank you.